Ski Studios in the house was cracking people. On point, precise, and precision. Triple threat. You know what I mean? Kind of like, whatever. I don't know because I gave up on it. You know, whatever. So anyways, it's Thursday. No, it ain't. It's Wednesday. Dude, the days have been mad. I've been working so much lately, man. And I'm just been so tired. But anyways, you guys don't want to hear about that. You know what I mean? I was at work earlier, and one of the girls, she was talking about, oh, her kids got locked in the car. I was like, you don't got that child safety lock? And boom. I'm like, you know what, dude? I never said that story, so I'll bring it up. I don't know how many years ago this was, 10, 15 years ago, a long time ago. Way past the statute of limitations. Let's hope so anyways. But so anyways, yeah, dude, it's me, three people, my man Jay, you know what I mean? Like, I always got a Jay in every story. But, you know, we're chilling, dude, in some broken down apartment. I don't know who owned the apartment. Somebody owned it that was friends with one of my friends. But anyways, we're in the apartment and we're getting sick. So, you know, who's going to do whatever, you know? I had a whip. I actually had a whip. And, like, we used to do returns and shit. But, which is like someone goes in, steals the shit out of, like, you know, Home Depot or Lowe's or wherever. And then someone walks back in, returns it, grabs a gift card, and then sells the gift card to the pawn shop. But that wasn't going to work today because everybody's license had already been used 3 times. And you can only do 3 times in a certain amount of time. It's all junky knowledge. But, so, anyways, I was like, you know what, bro? Call up, like, some shit, like, not a good dealer, because we didn't want to screw that, even though I have done that multiple times. But call up somebody, and, I'll get him. So, my man Jay, he got somebody in, Amesbury, Newburyport, somewhere out there. And, we go to get the kid. The kid's like, yeah, make sure you have the money, da 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 da, right? So, boom, hang up the phone. I'm like, bro, we got to get him in the car. We'll just say, oh, shit, we got to go to the ATM or some bullshit, whatever. So, anyways, we ride up. We start walking around. And I'm like, bro, I got to get the money. You know, my buddy makes, oh, Chris, what the hell, da da da. I'm like, come on, Jay, man, just let's go to the ATM. I got the money. Boom, boom, boom. So anyways, we get the kid to go into the car, right? And I'm in the front passenger, which I don't really like being in the passenger because I don't like having people behind me, especially on something like this. But, you know, you can't really, I don't know, you got to make the kid feel all right, right? So anyways, he's in the back and we start driving. And he had some people around, but, like, they didn't, like, walk with us. We were just supposed to walk down the street and do the deal real quick. We walked right to my car and freaking got him into the car, you know. So anyways, we're in the car. We get down a little bit, and I just turn around, and I go, hey, bro, I'm sorry, man, but you got to just give me everything. He's like, hey, all right. I go, bro, I'm not joking. Hand it over. He still thinks it's a joke. I had to hop over the back seat while my buddy's driving. And I'm like, yo, give me it. Boom, boom, boom. And, dude, I'm not the toughest guy, dude. I was just stupid back then. You know what I mean? The kid was a little smaller than me. I'm not a big kid. You know what I mean? But I will pull the trigger when the time comes. You know what I mean? So I hop in the back. I'm like, yo, give me it. Da-da-da. He thinks it's a joke, dude. I give him a couple hits. He goes to open the back door to jump out. Child safety locks on, motherfucker. You ain't getting out. So I give him a couple. I'm like, bro, I don't want to hurt you. Just give it over, dude, and I'm going to let you out. He reaches down to his sock, pulls out like 10 bags. Boom, boom, boom. Hands me it. And, you know, whatever. I throw it in my pocket. I roll the window down. I unlock the door from the outside, friggin' let the kid out. My friggin' buddy John just hits the fucking gas, bro, and fucking, I'm like, yo, dude, there's like a car full of people, like, rolling up on me. I'm like, running. I'm like, bro, let me in. Friggin', friggin', I have to run to catch the car. He friggin', you know, he slows down. I jump in, boom, I'm like, Yahtzee, right? He's like, all of a sudden, he gets a phone call, right? And we're like, happy, right? I'm calling the people back at the house. I'm like, yo, we got it. Yo, he gets a phone call. Yo, he's like, yo, it's fake. I go, what do you mean it's fucking fake, bro? The kid's selling fake shit? I fucking bite into the bag. Like, I don't even, like, try to untie. I just bite right into it. Fucking Raymond soup mix, dude. Like, fucking, I don't know, dude. Like, beef or some shit. I'm like, fuck, dude. Dude, I was pissed. I'm like, this fucking kid's selling fake shit. I guess John, like, my buddy John, man, he talked to the dude. He said I can use his name. So, I, you know, and I didn't even use the last name. So, I'm like, what? Bro, the kid's running around fake shit, bro. He should be beat up anyways. And then he's like, nah, dude, because he thought we were going to rob him or something. He thought you were going to rob him, bro? You didn't even rob people. He does burn people. He used to burn people, but he was never violent, dude. He was, like, honestly, man, he was a good kid. And I'll be honest, I was a good kid too, man. Like, but sometimes when you're down and out, man, like, you just turn into a different person. And I was talking to my man Ray, man, and I was just telling him, bro, I'm like, bro, it's like a movie, man. You know, can you believe, like, that we came out of that, man, and we're, like, we're different people, man. You know what I mean? Like, I'll be honest, like sometimes I think about it, and it's like, yeah, oh, yeah, I remember this. And it was like, yeah, it's a big fucking joke. Yeah, remember when you fought this kid, da-da-da, got your ass kicked? Because I did lose, I lost a few fights. I ain't going to lie on that one. Because I didn't have no meter on, like, yo, is this kid going to win? Or can I beat this fight? No, I would fight everyone. I fucking do it. I'll be straight up with you. I lost probably half. You know what I mean? Look at my fucking head. Look at my head. Boom. Look at right there, boom. Right there, boom. I know it's somewhere back here. You know what I mean? It's like, bro, I'm fucking scarred up. You know what I mean? Like, you go through a blender and come out with less staples, bro. One time, right, I went to the hospital because I had this shit. This one. The Mike Tyson line. I got, I'm in the hospital waiting, bro. And I'll tell you, when your head breaks open, that bleeds like a sieve. So, I'm laying there, right? And all of a sudden, dude, staple in my head. I'm like, yo, man, that hurts. Because, like, it's, dude, my thing was flapped open, bro. Like, straight up, dude. Like, from here to here, it was just spread. And it's like, dude, when he's stapling it, like, it not only hooks it, but then it pulls it together. So it's like ripping your hair together. That hurts. You know what? I'll give you guys a bonus one. I got a better one. And this one is a nightmare. I don't know, man. I should do another video for that one. Well, anyways, I'll tell you this, right? I got stabbed, right? And I was in the hospital. You know what I mean? And they got this thing. It's called a catheter. And when you are severely laid up and they don't want you to move, they take it and it's like the size of, see this? Like a cigarette? It's like the size of this. And the guy, doctor comes over and he's like, hey, Al, you know, I told you we're going to have to put that catheter in. And I'm like, I go, that end's going in? That end? Because it's just unbelievable, dude. Like, you know what I mean? Like, bro, in your hole of your piece, bro? That's crazy. So, anyways, right, I got the thing in, right, and, like, dude, you can see the bag, right, of, like, all where all your urine comes out. So, I'm sitting in there, and, laying in there, matter of fact, and, I feel like I gotta go to the bathroom tremendously. So, man, it's crazy even thinking about it, right? So, I'm hitting the button, yo, nurse, whatever, get in here, right? So, she's like, oh, well, you have internal bleeding. She's like, but, what's going on is the blood is formed a clot. And there's a clot inside. So what I have to do is I have to the catheter, it's this thing, and then there's a big tube that comes out and goes to a bag, and it goes in far. Like, I'm not joking. It probably goes in like this far. It's crazy. That much tubing up your penis, bro. That shit's crazy. So anyways, right? I'm talking like that because I don't know. I don't even know if it really matters, dude. I swear anyway. But so anyways, right? I'm in there, and she's like, it's gonna hurt, but then it's gonna feel like relief. Because it's like, dude, I'm telling you, I even pissed in like 12 hours probably, right? And I'm like, I go, you know what? Just go for it. Go for it as hard as you can because I just want it done. I know it's gonna hurt, but it'll be done. You know what I mean? I'm on like Demerol and everything. That was actually the beginning of my opiate use. Great, huh? That's how I got hooked on. But anyways. So anyway, she goes and she rams it, boom, nothing. I'm like, ah, right? So she's going. Dude, like a minute goes by. It didn't bust through yet. I'm like, I go, fuck it, take this thing out of me. Just get it out of me. She's like, oh, I can't do that. I go, can you please take this? Dude, I'm begging this lady. Can you please take the thing out? Please, I can't do that. I can't. Because, dude, she's been trying for friggin' over a minute, she can't do it. I grab her hand and I go, cause dude, I'm begging her to take it out and she's not doing it. I go, oh, I go, I guess. I go, you know what? I don't even need you. I'm just gonna take it out myself. She goes, oh, well, there's a balloon on the other end, and if you pull it out, it's gonna hurt worse. And she's like smirking at me. Like, what, bitch? I fucking grab her hand and I say, you take this fucking thing out or I'm gonna rip your fucking hand off. She's calling all the other nurses. I go, get this thing out. I'm freaking out. Freaking out, dude. Dude, there's other people in there, dude. They can see what she's doing. Dude, this feels like Saw. I'll tell you what, I wouldn't let go of her hand, and I'll tell you what, she undid it and she took that fucking thing out. Bro, that dude, that's crazy. You're supposed to be a nurse. You're supposed to be helping people. You're probably doctor to death, bitch. You know what I mean? Like, bro, I said, do not bring that nurse to my room again. She wanted me in pain. You know what I mean? Like, that's the type. She probably went home with some dude that beat her, and she comes in and takes the stuff out on me. Like, really? I didn't do nothing wrong, man. I was super nice in there. You know what I mean? But come on. Like, this is crazy. And then when it came out, I didn't want the thing back in, and they were trying to argue with me over it. Dude, I ain't putting that back in. You know how, you wouldn't even take it out when I couldn't even piss. You know what I mean? Like, dude, you know what I mean? Like, they would have had to friggin', and I'll tell you what, man, I ain't joking. For a man, that's like almost like rape. I felt like I was raped by a nurse. And this big, that's crazy. And it's like a solid pen. I do it. It's still unbelievable. That's part of my movie, man. I'll tell you, bro. Whatever. I don't even know how this one came out. You know what I mean? I've been tired a lot lately. I know though, like, you know, you're supposed to stick with it, keep coming every day. You blah, 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 boom. I know that shit didn't even make sense. And the thing that sucks, dude, I caught, because I recorded two other videos before this one, and I don't know how to edit or nothing. So, someone called in, ruined the video. Then the next one, I said something I shouldn't have said. I have no clue how to cut the stuff out. So I had to freaking go back and re-record the whole thing. I need help, you guys, man. Somebody help me. You know what I mean? What am I supposed to say? Until that. You guys, man, I'll tell you this, man. You never know when it's your last day, or when it's your buddy's last day, or your mom's last day, or your dog's last day. So I'll tell you this. Always try to keep everything good, man. Tell everybody you love them. Tell everybody you care about them. You know what I mean? Because you never know. You know what I mean? And you just don't want it to be the last day and you got into a fight with somebody. I'm just saying that because some of the people I lost was on my mind. You know what I mean? RIP to my mans out there. They're gone, bro. All right. Until then, Ski Studios, I'm out.